Guarda che è tornato sulla traccia, solita melanconia sulla faccia. Non mi faccio mai sentire, dici, ma mi trovi di sentire, chiedilo ai miei veri amici.
Guarda che è tornato sulla traccia, solita melanconia.
È tornato sulla traccia, solita melanconia sulla traccia. Non mi faccio mai sentire, dici, ma mi trovi.
Guarda che è tornato sulla traccia, solita melanconia sulla faccia. Non mi faccio mai sentire, dici, ma mi trovi di sentire.
We have here SiTraNo, which is an app that we have developed. Decomposition methods that allow us to separate the sound into its three, we can say, independent or core components. The signs, which comprise everything that resembles whistling sounds. Noise, which is something akin to hisses and nuances of the sound. And transients, which are clicks, essentially. Our idea was that we can imagine any kind of sound, doesn't matter how simple or complex they are, as a summation of these three independent events. But then the interesting part is that we can combine these three components however we want. Okay, so this is me rapping.
Guarda che è tornato sulla traccia, solita melanconia sulla faccia.
So if, for example, I want most of my raspiness but keep the harshness of the clicks, it's gonna sound like that.
Guarda che è tornato sulla traccia, solita melanconia sulla faccia.
But then I can decide, okay, I want to reduce the raspiness a little bit, just add something to the clicks of the consonants.
Guarda che è tornato sulla traccia, solita melanconia sulla faccia.
Or even less, we can go even down.
Guarda che è tornato sulla traccia, solita melanconia sulla faccia.
So one application that we have tested our SDN decomposition with is dynamic range compression, which is very common in audio processing, and especially music, because we all like to hear music really loud. But when we have lots of transients, they tend to occupy most of the dynamic of the sound. There are many ways of working with them, compressors, limiters, but of course they introduce non-linearities that are going to distort the sound. But using the SDN decomposition and having access to the transients only allows us to basically reduce every attack or every drum sound without introducing non-linearities, which is pretty cool. If you look at the dynamic, it goes from 1 to minus 1, occupying the whole dynamic with this transient, especially in this area.
Solita melanconia sulla faccia.
That is the ch sound that is very harsh and is occupying a lot of space in the dynamic. But then if we reduce the transients energy from, let's say, from 100% to 50%, we are freeing 3 or 4 dB of space, and it's gonna sound this way.
Solita melanconia sulla faccia, non mi faccio mai sentire, dici.
So it's a little softer, but it doesn't affect the overall sound or the overall loudness that much, but it's freeing up to 3 to 4 dB in the dynamics of the sound, which means that we can apply a gain for 3 to 4 dB and everything is going to sound louder. And we know that consumers usually like louder sounds.
So this new decomposition method opens many interesting possibilities in audio processing. We saw examples of dynamic range compression. In addition, we are interested in time stretching of sound. For example, when you see sports news and slowed down version of a sports event, it's usually a silent film. And I think this shows that there is no good solution, good quality solution to do this currently. We are using deep neural networks now for slowing down the noisy part. And I believe this is going to be the new best method for doing that.